Okay, you're 11. Today we are going to learn about what specific heat capacity is, and hopefully by the end of this video you'll have a better understanding of what that phrase means. I want you to imagine you're at the beach, and here we've got the sun, and the sun is giving the same amount of energy to both the sand and the water. But even though it's the same amount of energy, you'll notice that the sand actually heats up a lot quicker and to a higher temperature than what the water does. So even though the same amount of energy, the sand will have a larger rise in temperature than the water. This is because when we put the same amount of heat into some materials, it actually gives a bigger temperature rise in one than it might in the other. So let's use another example of this. If we have two beakers and we put the same amount of water in one as an amount of oil in the other, let's say 1 kilogram of each, water and oil, and we heat both of them for the same amount of time at the same temperature. What we would actually find in this experiment is that even though we've got identical volumes of water and oil, and they're both heated at the same amount of time, so for 1 minute, the oil will actually heat up to 60 degrees while the water will only heat to 30. So the same amount of heat produces twice the temperature rise in oil than it does in the water. To make the water reach the same temperature as the oil, we would have to add twice the amount of heat to the water. This means that water has twice the capacity to absorb and store heat energy as the oil. So we say that water has a higher heat capacity than oil. I'd like you to write this down. This is our definition for specific heat capacity. So, specific heat capacity is the amount of heat energy in joules needed to raise the temperature of a substance, a kilogram of that substance, by 1 degree Celsius. And our units for that are in joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. So hopefully this helps you to understand what specific heat capacity is, and that we know water actually has a really high specific heat capacity compared to other substances, for example, the oil, and the sand in this video as well. So hopefully this will give you a bit of an introduction into where we're going in next lesson.